The backbone of the Kharadron air fleets are the Arkanaut companies. These grizzled privateers crew the Skyport's vessels. In this video, we'll be showing you how to paint the company captain from the Arkanaut Company box quickly and easily in less than 10 paints. And by following this guide, you'll have the whole squad ready to repel boarders and take the fighting to their enemies before you know it. So the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model, and for this we've chosen to use lead belcher, as there's quite a lot of silver on the model. This will give us a head start and really speed up the painting process. You'll also need to have a pot of lead belcher to hand, just in case we need to do any tidying up of mistakes. The paints you'll need to follow along with this guide are listed on screen now. We'll be painting this captain in the Barrack Nar scheme, as per the box art. But remember, you're free to let your imagination run wild and paint your miniatures however you like. If you're new to painting, you can check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos to learn all about it. The series is linked in the description box below. So the first thing we're going to do is actually paint over all those silver areas with lead belcher from the pot. This might seem a little odd seeing as we've already undercoated with lead belcher. However, the paint from the pot has a slightly different finish to the spray can, so if we make any mistakes, this just means we can tidy up really easily. We don't need to worry about being neat here at all, so just get that paint on and make sure you get it into all those little areas. Make sure you do thin the paint down just a little bit, but you probably will only need one coat of this. However, if we haven't quite got the coverage we're looking for, we can just apply another thin layer. Once all the silver's finished, we're going to move on to the gold areas, and for these we'll be using Balthazar Gold. We're using a small base brush at the moment. It's small enough to help us be neat, but also large enough to help us be a little bit quicker. Just be careful around the silver areas that we've already painted. We can always tidy up any mistakes, but it does save time if we don't have to. It doesn't matter too much here which areas are silver and gold, so it's really up to you which parts of the model you choose to pick out in each colour. However, the box art is always there as a guide, so feel free to refer to that if you want to. Now that we've base coated the metallics, we're actually going to apply a couple of shades, starting off with Drakenhof Nightshade for the silver areas. This will give that armour a nice blue tinge which we can see in the box art. Take your time, working carefully around all those silver areas. If you find the paint pooling too much anywhere, just clean off your brush and use that to soak up any excess. We want to avoid too much pooling in those recesses. Once the Drakenhof Nightshade is completely dry, we can move on to shading the gold areas with Agrax Earthshade. This is another shade paint, so apply it just as you did with the Drakenhof Nightshade. Work around the model in small sections, taking your time to be as neat as you can. When you're using shades, it's a good idea to make sure there's not any water on your brush before you dip into the pot. This is because water on your brush could dilute the paint and give us an inconsistent finish on the model. Once both shades are fully dry, we're going to move on to dry brushing all those metallics. We'll be using a small dry brush with Necron Compound. This is a really nice bright silver and it works well over both the silver areas and the gold. It might seem strange to dry brush now, but we're doing this so that we can be a little bit messier before we paint in the rest of the details. When you're dry brushing, it's important to remove as much paint from the brush as possible before you apply it to the miniature. So you can work the paint off onto a paper towel or some cardboard, just leaving a small amount of pigment on the brush. Then you work it over the raised details of the miniature in back and forth and circular motions. Doing this will just catch those raised edges and create a really quick and easy highlight. Start off with a soft pass of the paint. It's easier to build up layers of dry brushing than it is to correct an overenthusiastic dry brush. We're using Necron Compound for this. This is a specially formulated dry paint which is perfect for dry brushing. However, if you don't have this at home, Stormhost Silver could be a really good alternative. Once you've finished dry brushing, it's always a good idea to dust off the model with a clean brush. Sometimes dry brushing leaves little particles of paint on the model, and we don't want these to set when we're painting over them. Once the metallics are completely dry, we'll be moving on to those overalls, and for these we'll be base coating them in that signature colour, Barrack Nar Burgundy. We've switched to a small layer brush here, as we need to be a little bit neater around all those details we've already finished. This is a base paint again, so make sure to thin it with a little bit of water and build it up on the miniature in a couple of layers. The next thing to do is to pick out the straps and the gloves, and for these we'll be using Xandri Dust. Take your time around those areas that we've already painted, but if you do make any mistakes, you can just tidy back up with the previous colours. Again, we're sticking with that small airbrush as it'll help us be neater and gives us more control of the paint. Next, we'll be using Temple Guard Blue, and we'll be using this to pick out the eyes and some lenses. This is a really nice, bright and piercing blue. So painting these small details in such a punchy colour will really draw the eye to them. You'll notice we've only got one area left of the miniature unpainted. So let's get those boots painted with Abaddon Black. This is obviously a strong colour, so we do need to take our time and be as neat as we can. But as always, you can just tidy up mistakes if you need to. Now with all the base coats done, we're going to move on to some more shades. We're going to use Norn Oil to shade the overalls, the eyes and the lenses. Doing this will really add some depth to the miniature and help tie it all together. These are larger areas, so we can switch back to that small base brush if we want to. Next, we're going back to Agrax Earthshade, and we'll be using this to shade the gloves and the straps. Agrax Earthshade is really versatile. It works fantastically over a variety of base coats. Over pale colours, it can be a good idea to thin it down with a little bit of water. This will just give us a more subtle effect. And if you find you want more depth in the recesses, you can just carefully apply some Agrax Earthshade straight into them. And there we are, your Arkanaut Company Captain is complete, ready to lead his band of privateers across the skies on their next expedition. You can see that our model is based in Astrogranite, and if you'd like to learn more about basing, you can check out our video all about it. For more tutorials, tips and tricks, you can head to your local Warhammer store where our amazing staff will be happy to help, or check out citadelcolour.com. Well, we hope you've enjoyed the video and we'll see you next time. Bye!